in January, and yes, I'm finally back from my holidays. And by the way, the makeup lady hasn't cocked up. I really do look this orange. Thank you to Richard Mayne for filling in while I was away. Nowhere too exotic, so you know, as exotic as Hull, because the East Yorkshire port seems to be the place to be right now. More than 200,000 people watched a stunning light and sound show at City Hall last weekend, part of the celebrations for Hull being UK City of Culture 2017. Kingston upon Hull, birthplace to such artistic luminaries as poet Philip Larkin and to Tracy Thorne from The England Girl, has also got an upended whale on display in Prince's Quay Shopping Centre, and most extraordinary of all, a 75-metre-long wind turbine blade in nearby Queen Victoria Square. Once voted, of course, the worst place in the country to live, you have to wonder if being UK City of Culture can change that. Well, let's ask the panel, shall we? Down the far end, Janet. Come on, you've been heading up to Hull sometime this year.
I'd love to go.
Some of them say it's had a lasting effect, others that it was just a sort of window dressing. And that,
well, it's just an association of ideas. I mean, there is something of a north-south divide here, and I think it's quite good if we have to go to them, really.
So you'll be going, you'll be
I'll
going.
I'll be going, yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
In the middle, Dr. David Ball, good morning to you. There are rumours going around that you've never been north of Birmingham.
That is absolutely untrue. I used to work in Birmingham for BBC Birmingham for many, many years. Because Hull, I think, had a period of time where it was a little neglected. Yeah. So, therefore, anything that makes people go and that celebrates culture is brilliant. And actually, the wind turbine...
What about if you didn't spend the money on light shows, but you spent the money on improved rail and road infrastructure, helping the port rival that of Seabrook?
But there was a really important interview, which Janet alluded to, which was the guys who make the wind turbines. They're made in Hull, and they're celebrating what is amazing technology, which is the future, eco-power. Celebration of that city. Why not?
Why not? Why not indeed? What time to introduce our special guest this morning? From Liverpool, it's Labour's Luciana Cosey. Nice to see you. So, before the proper introduction, did being City of Culture have a lasting impact on Liverpool?
I think it did, yes. I mean, the overwhelming majority of people that they reflect on that year that we had and what's happened since then, there's just so much vibrant culture and activity going on all the time in the city of Liverpool. Not just for people that live across Merseyside, but they come from right across the country to enjoy
it. So it'll work for Hull as well, do you think?
Oh, definitely. I know my colleagues in Hull are really, really very excited about what's going to happen over the course of the coming years. There's so much planning and investment in terms of, you know, the programme that will take place. It's really quite exciting.
I'm going up there in the spring to see you there.
But your point about whether you choose between rail and infrastructure or culture, actually, we need both.
Yes,
and culture's really
do.
Very important to everything that happens in all of our communities.
Yeah, no, true. Luciano is a representative.